श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। चेब्रोलू इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ईसीई फाइनल ईयर ईसीई फाइनल ईयर ईसीई सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन। सो एज पर जेएनटीयू के सिलेबस आंध्र प्रदेश, सो टुडे फोर्थ ईसीई सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन टॉपिक ऑन बोर्ड प्रोसेसिंग। सो इन अवर मल्टीपल एक्सेसिंग टेक्निक्स टुडे सो माय विश टू एक्सप्लेन ऑन बोर्ड प्रोसेसिंग। सो फ्रॉम द नॉलेज ऑफ ट्रांसमीटर पावर इन द टीडीएमए नेटवर्क, सो हियर आई रिप्रेजेंट वन मॉडल प्रॉब्लम। So considers a typical VSAT at the station in particular country. So that is a part of TDMA network using 54 megahertz bandwidth transponder. So on a domestic KU band GEO satellite, so VSAT at the station has 1 meter antenna that transmit 64 kbps signal at 14 gigahertz. So the TDMA network uses QPSK modulation and all the transmitters have symbol rate 30 mbps. So we will set the value 20 dB. So calculate uplink transmitter power by using the following system parameters. So first we wanted to calculate the carrier noise ratio, so that is channel noise ratio for uplink frequency. So the uplink power and the noise budget represented in the given table. So this is the supported data mentioned here. Earth station transmitted power, earth station antenna gain, so 41 dB. Satellite antenna receiving gain 32 dB. So edge of the beam loss 3 dB and other losses are 1 dB. So at 14 gigahertz path loss given by 2207 dB. So power at transponder input, so this is the power at, so Boltzmann constant, noise bandwidth, transponder noise temperature 27 dB, and a transponder input to noise, so minus 126.8 dB. So this is the supported data. So from this valid information, so we know that channel to noise ratio uplink 20 dB. So from our previous formula, so implement to formula to note down this value. So from the previous formula, we have the value. So that is the power at a transponder input. So use this PT minus 136.6 plus existing here 128, clear? So in the question they mentioned 128. So from this step, PT equals to 30. So dBW. So convert this dBW into known watt, 1200 watt. So to achieve this CNR of 20 dB in the transponder, so the uplink transmitted power, so this is the uplink transmitted power, so the value given by 20 plus 137 minus 156.5, so that equals to 1.3 watt. So calculate the uplink power. So the total transmitted power for this one, 1.3 watt. So in this way, simple problems might be asked in SEM examination. So after completion of transmitter power, so we have here onboard processing. So as per JNT UK syllabus, so in fourth unit, next topic, onboard processing. So it is a theoretical understanding. So in our uplink design or multiple accessing techniques, so bent pipe, so bent pipe transponder structure is one of the well-known architecture in our board style. So by using bent pipe transponder, so the given RF signal is to be amplified and received from the ground earth station. Therefore, it will come back to earth station for a different frequency. So for this implementation, so bent pipe transponder has the greatest advantage as well as flexibility. So in practical field, in practical onboard communication in the satellite telecommunication system, so the application is just for adding or combining the signals. So for that application, the transponder is the common element. So the transponder can be used for to combine the signal with its prior fixed bandwidth. So everybody know the bandwidth requirement for the satellite communication system. So for this illustration, so consider a link between a small earth station and to large hub. Clear? So via this GEO satellite transponder. So to better understand on this onboard processing, just illustration taken here. So a virtual link can be established between small earth station and large hub station by using GEO satellite transponder. For this illustration, there will be usually a small rain fade margin on the uplink from the transmitting station. So why? Because in this transmitting station literature, we found small low value of EIRP. So when the rain affects the uplink, so automatically the parameter CNR in the transponder will fall. So with this influence, what happened on the CNR parameter? The overall CNR in the gateway station automatically receives the signal with the greater than CNR ratio in the transponder. So by all this situation, the resultant BER at the gateway station will increase quickly as rain affects the uplink frequency. So this will be done by implementing all this required setup on your live board. So while performing CNR, so in the gateway earth station, generally small amount of error to be monitored. So therefore the solution for this problem, forward error correction. So automatically this FEC scheme implemented on this coding on the link, so which shows the data throughput, but it is actually need for less than 5% of the time. So this is the actual round trip delay. So the delay provided by this link automatically configured 5%. So adaptive coding. So to eliminate this forward error, so some signal processing scheme adopted during the earth station monitoring stage. So one of that advantage is here adaptive coding and modulation. So this type of method implemented for ADCM. So adaptive coding and modulation can be used to control this carrier to noise ratio for the uplink, as well as small earth station information is automatically get affected by this forward errors. So to overcome all this type of the preliminary problems, so we have to preferable to maintain the connection at the lower rate than to allow outage to occur. So this type of technique automatically implemented in the communication of the satellite for regular data and internet access. So while this treatment, while this illustration is going on, so the attenuation is monitored, attenuation is observed during the uplink design. So when attenuation is contoured for your uplink design, so automatically during the rain stage, or simply called uplink attenuation in the rain. So uplink attenuation in the rain. So onboard processing or baseband processing transponder used to overcome this problem just by separating the uplink and downlink signals and their corresponding carrier to noise ratio. So with this knowledge, a baseband processing transponder can also have different modulation schemes on the uplink and downlink to improve spectral efficiency and dynamically apply the forward error control to only those links affected by this rain attenuation regularly. So in the transponder style, so on live at earth station stage, so they have baseband transponder, are simply called a baseband processing transponders. So these baseband processing transponder, they have different modulation schemes, so which may be uplink and downlink, so to improve the spectral efficiency. So based upon this system configuration, some LEO satellite providing mobile telephone service by using this onboard processing technique. So with this onboard processing technique, LEO satellites, LEO satellite category, they have provide satellite application for the remote users. To serve this station services to the remote users, these LEO satellite transponders may use Ka band for internet access to all individual users and for better quality on services like IoT applications. So this is the one type of baseband processing transponders. So this will indicate a baseband processing transponder with multiple beam antenna. So you are familiar about narrow beam and wide beam, multiple beam antenna structures. So schematic diagram of on this baseband processing, so they have multiple beam antennas. So this multiple beam antennas may be focused on this individual transponder. So we have here input antenna that is connected to so the receiving antenna and local noise amplifier and a receiver are similar to bent pipe transponder. So, but the signals are demodulated and individual packets that are recovered at this baseband. So the headers are extracted from the packets and the address of the receiving earth station that is used to send the beam selection and instruction to the multiple beam downlink antenna. So this selection of instructions to the multiple beam downlink antenna, so the baseband packets are passed to the transmitter for transmission by the selected beam. So when the recovery packets are identified at the packet recovery stage, so these identified packets are substituted to a demultiplexer, where the individual packets are split and the corresponding baseband signal is identified. So this baseband signal is applied to header creation, where the packet attains proper preamble bit and header bit. So this header is priorly applied to the beam formation through the transmitter. So like this, the signal is transmitted by the satellite to all the local earth devices. So this diagram is indicating a baseband processing transponder structure. So very multiple times asked in the JNT UK question papers. So baseband processing transporter constructional diagram. here the operation once again I mentioned here. So the kit has receiver, baseband processing unit, and a transmitter. So the received signal from the uplink is converted so to an IF and demodulated to recovery the baseband signal, which is then processed and reassembled. So from the stage, baseband signal is modulated on a carrier at a downlink frequency and transmitted back to the earth. So baseband processing allows control the information that to be extracted from the uplink signal so that individual packets and frames are routed to different downlink frames. So it is easy operation from our previous diagram. So generally these baseband processing is virtual circuits. So they have between gateway station. So with the multiple beam satellite, so GEO satellites are initialized during 2010, which will increase the earlier generations. So by using this baseband technique, so while calculating the CNR value for the uplink and the downlink, so here we have to set this both onboard processing as well as the satellite for to maintain this uplink and downlink together. So now when carrier to noise ratio, which is used by this uplink and downlink, so generally they implement the CNR formula, which is used to calculate the uplink and downlink frequencies. So these uplink and downlink frequencies are further to be modified to evaluate BER value. So by BER, these link data should be added, and finally we got results which are be evaluated under BER ratio. So the receiving earth stations automatically calculate this BER. So therefore, noise powers are added to this reciprocal formula. Suppose if the carrier to noise ratio of uplink is very low, so because of uplink rain fade effect, so the bit errors will be present in the recovery data that should be available in the transponder. So if this CNR value is very high, so the usually case, so there are various network topologies are being implemented for the large gate station. So while implementing these values, so there we required separation of uplink and downlink signals, so which allows various different categories of the modulation methods that should be employed on this onboard technique, which will be able to get the error correction codes in prior order. So there are various mesh topologies available in the regular communication satellite systems. For example, star. So if the star topology, so if the star topologies are to be implemented, so therefore automatically, so the uplink and downlink between these satellites and the gateway station. So if the CNR on this downlink is very high, if the CNR of on this downlink is very high, so then we have to create further high level modulation which is having 16 bit and 32 bits. So that way I will explain in the later. Thank you for everyone for your active participation for this online session. So stay home, stay safe.